Hey there, friends. It's your bad couch guru, Lynn Lemberg, and I enjoyed my conversation on Thursday with Staci Alden from Pro Sports Club, director of the group fitness team there of 200 people based out of the Seattle area. I enjoyed that so much that I wanted to bring her back to talk to us again. So Staci, welcome back to the Couch to Active podcast. Thank you.
Thank you.
And Staci, you and I got talking after the first podcast we did, and you had some really good tips and information from some of the best experts out there about taking care of yourself during this time. And so I just wanted to give you the floor for a few minutes to talk to our Couch to Active friends.
Ah, awesome. I'm excited to share, just because when all of this happened, a lot of us fitness professionals were trying to learn how to use technology, like I explained last time. But also they were sending us all these great tips on taking care of yourself and just trying to do your best to keep your health as close to the same as it is going to be after all of this is over as possible. It's not going to be. And I think I enjoyed that as well, just accepting the fact that we are going to be sitting more, just because it is really hard not to be when you're at home all day. And whether you're working from home or you're used to working from home, it's still so different. I've heard from people, because it's not just them anymore who are working from home. It's everyone. So they aren't able to just grab a friend and go to the park and do the normal things they'd like to do. So what I had taken from what people were saying in the fitness industry were, number one, to try to have some sort of a schedule during this time, doing the best you can to not necessarily sleep all the way till noon, like you
maybe for the first couple days.
Yeah, exactly. I'll give you that. Okay. Give you that. And then,
because that's what I did.
That's good. It's all good. Totally good. And then finding, you know, maybe the first thing you do is go outside for a walk. And then the next thing you do, or before that, maybe you make your coffee and bring it with you. So kind of, it doesn't have to be like a schedule of to-dos, but a routine that you would build at home that involves some sort of movement. I'm grateful that we can keep going to the grocery store, because fresh food doesn't last as long as we might want it to. And so I've enjoyed being able to stock up on that as well. And then just having the non-perishable items just ready to go if they're needed.
Yeah.
But trying to eat as much fresh food as you possibly can, and really trying to be with yourself as much as possible is something that I appreciated. Someone had mentioned, and that this is a time of our lives that it is going to be a good time to potentially, if you have a partner and they are there with you, get to know them the best that you can. Get to know your kids really well, enjoy your time with your kids.
Yeah.
But also, if you aren't in as busy of a house or a household, then just taking time to just enjoy your own company, I guess.
Yeah.
Just to, and write down your thoughts and find other things to do rather than watch the news all day.
Oh my gosh. Yes.
That is depressing in itself.
It
the
is.
The numbers are just going to keep climbing. And that's something we have to acknowledge and just know it's gonna keep happening.
No, those are great tips. And the food one, I came across some really dumb luck. I actually have a friend of mine who's a nutritionist, and I signed up for a 2-week reboot thing with her. Yeah, she's a holistic nutritionist. So it's not like a extreme cleanser, you know, take these pills and powders and you'll be great. You know, nothing like that. Yeah. Got the recipes and everything, and literally got the whole kitchen ready for this like 2 days before quarantine happened. So except for the fact that now sometimes I go through my cupboards and there's only healthy junk in there. And I'm like, darn it, there's only healthy food. I think really good for me, because I did get sick and it hit me hard, and it kind of freaked me out. But I had all the real healthy, fresh food and time to heal really quickly.
And I would say on that actual point is that, all those healthy foods not only are going to help you stay fit and healthy during this time, but also your immune system needs all those vitamins and minerals and vitamin C drinks can only give you so much.
Yeah.
There's vitamin D and there's iron and there's so much. There's folate. There's all this great fiber and your digestive system is
happy.
I'm not a nutritionist at all, but it's
happy.
Really important part of your immune system. Yeah.
My listener knows I'm very open about my digestive system and they're very happy that mine is happy right now. So
yeah, no, that's so good. It's so important. And it's So what I found is like even those greens, those that you can use, there's all kinds of different mixes of them, but like at the vitamin shop or GNC, just getting a big tub of those greens, I feel like help me just know that even if I don't eat enough vegetables, maybe that day I've got a little extra.
You got your greens. Yeah. So what has changed for you at home? What's been the most helpful for you now that you're not running around a gym all day, every day?
Oh, that's a great question. The hardest part for me is I love strength training, like heavy strength training. And so if I could just pick up like deadlift, something really heavy, my couch maybe might work. And looking at it, might be if I can find a good handhold of it and get a couple sets in. But that has been the hardest part. I think that's been a good thing in a way to let my body recover from all the strength training I do, and
interesting,
and just get some cardio in and walks and and all the stores are running out of dumbbells.
Oh wow!
Yeah, it's kind of funny, but like Target has like they only have 2 pounds left. You could use a can of beans instead.
And so 2 pounds. That. Oh my gosh. Okay. So Staci, you have to promise me someday when you do lift your couch, because you just need to take a picture because I want to share it so we can see. I actually want you to do this now.
I will. Oh my gosh. But I will say my secret, I would say for anyone who wants to do some strength training, I'm actually a little sore yesterday and I'm surprised by it. The TRX suspension trainer.
Yeah.
All of their classes right now are free online. I think during this time, actually, FYI, I should have said that the last minute.
That's okay.
If you can hang it on like a pole or go to the park and hang it, I think in certain gates you can use, as long as you can't go in the fields right now. But yeah, that has been amazing. Good core workout, good strength, and love that.
The TRX. Yeah. Google it, folks, TRX. If you haven't heard about it. Yeah. I may have to do an episode on TRX. Cool.
Yeah.
Oh, Staci, thank you so much for coming back on again. Yeah. And seriously, good luck to you. Stay healthy.
Thank you. You too. And to all your listeners too. My thoughts.
Yes, absolutely. All right. Thanks so much. Bye-bye now.
Bye.
Exercise should not be dreadful, but getting off the couch, we know, is the hardest exercise of all. Did you know that Couch to Active has an app? It's the easiest way to keep track of and follow the Couch to Active podcast. So head on over to your app store, and it doesn't matter whether you're on an iPhone, a tablet, or an Android device. Search for Couch to Active, that's T-O Active, download the app, and check it out. Bye-bye now.